I think I was scoring too much, so my dad stopped it.
Yeah,
and
yeah.
He said, and he set a new one. He said, if you score a header, and I never scored a header until when I was in Holland, and I saw him obviously after the game.
Was he there?
Was he there?
How has
that just happened? I scored a header.
Where's the sweet? Yes, guys, what's happening? I'm Billy Wingrove, and I'm joined with the tech master himself, Mason Mount. Do you like that, tech master?
Yeah, that's nice.
I was going to say baller, I thought it's got to be tech master. That's got to be it. So, Mason, thanks for joining us. I want to start from the beginning, the very beginning. I mean, you got spotted for Chelsea when you were 6 years old, is that right?
Yeah, six, yeah.
When did you first discover that you was good at football?
Probably a bit later on. When you're that age, it's like you're just playing and you're just loving football. It's not really like any focus on pressure of doing well. So I was just enjoying it at that time. So I didn't really know how good I was. Probably scoring some own goals. I remember scoring some own goals when I first started.
Who didn't?
I don't think I was like that good at that young age. Yeah. I just remember coming home from school. I'd go to school in the morning, in the day, and then literally pick me up from school, I'm straight in the car, we go to football, yeah. And obviously an hour and a half travelling, I'm getting my training kit on in the car, buzzing to train.
But you're loving it,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, just like, loving it, yeah. I'm buzzing, I'm not tired, and then obviously go back to school the next day, go home, so yeah, it's something that I love doing.
Did you get back in the car after training and fall asleep?
After a long day,
school, training, and then go to sleep
on the way home, that was time to relax.
Moving into like youth level now, you had a really decent youth team, didn't you? You cleared up.
Yeah, it was alright.
What is it like? Like, did that help your development as a player, playing with players around you that were so good as well?
Yeah.
You know, you had like one of the best teams around from what I can see.
Yeah, we had a very strong team. I mean, you can see some of the players that are coming through now, like me, Reece. Tam is a year older, but I played up with him and Fikayo. It's like top players that have coming through, Cal, and we're all coming through together now, so it's obviously exciting for us. But when we was younger, we knew we had a strong team, and when you come up against the likes of Arsenal and Tottenham's, you're thinking, oh, this is a massive game, we want to win. And we just loved playing football together, and that was it. And we used to win quite a few tournaments, quite a few games. And that's the love of the game. You want to play in these tournaments and win, and it was all about enjoying it at the time, but you know, deep down there's that pressure of winning games and winning tournaments with Chelsea, such a big thing. So yeah, it was a very enjoyable time. But I think the things you learn most is from the games you don't win, like the tournaments you get to a final and you lose, and
yeah.
I think them little things when you lose the big games or anything like that, that's where you learn the most. You learn about going into the game, what could I have done, or in the game, what could I have done better? And then after the game, the disappointment, you remember that feeling, you don't want to have that feeling again. And for us, we did have that feeling sometimes, probably more winning than losing, but you remember them times you lost, and you obviously don't want it to happen ever again.
Moving into your loan spells, so you've had like a great couple of few years in the youth team, and then you get asked to go out on loan to Vitesse.
Yeah.
How was the difference between the Test and Derby County? What did you learn from going to Holland and playing over there?
Yeah, so I went there when I was 18. That was when I first went out there. Different experience for me. I had a year of under 23s football at Chelsea, and I decided at the end of that it was time to, okay, I need to get a different type of experience. I need to go abroad. We chose for Tess, and it was the perfect option for me. The first couple months was very difficult. I wasn't playing. Difficult for me to kind of get used to the environment. It's professional football. It's something I've never been involved in or used to. And I kind of learned the first couple months in training, giving my everything, just trying to show the manager what I can do. I mean, I'm a young kid coming in from a big club. I don't think he trusted me at the beginning. And that was something I learned to work and show someone that they can trust me and I can play. And I remember having my debut, I come on in the game and I scored within 30 seconds or a minute, and that was for me like all these the months of hard work come down to this moment. I've got to take my chance, take my opportunity. So yeah, that was a brilliant year for me, going out there and learning, and then a year older going to Derby, more experienced, knowing more about football. And it was a different type of football. It's, you know,
different style.
Yeah, you know what the championship's like. It's tough. There's big players, older, experienced players that I could learn off, not just from my team, but in the league as well. I remember coming up against some of the players from other teams, and they're doing the dark arts of football. Yeah, you know, I'm talking about little kicks here and there, and trying to get in my head, saying, "Oh, you're a young kid. What are you doing here?" All this, and that happens in football.
So you've seen a lot of your friends that you've grown up, played football with, come through the ranks at Chelsea, but also other teams. Declan Rice is a prime example, he's a top bloke as well. What's it like seeing them come through, and is there like any banter that flies between you in the lead up to games playing against each other? Is it what happens during a match? I'm intrigued to see what kind of happens before, during and after. Because if it's me, I'd just be bantering before, bantering him on the pitch, and then bantering if we win. And if you lose, you switch your phone off. One of them ones.
Yeah, I remember last season we did an interview like a week before, just leading up to the game, and it was all right. And then after that, we'd go, okay, we'll have one more day, and then after that, we're not speaking. We're giving 3 days leading up to the game. I'm not speaking to you.
Yeah.
And then obviously you see him on game day, you say, all right, we're about to go to battle, we're about to go to war, yeah. And then we play the game, and then hopefully we win. That's the most important thing. I want to beat him. And then after the game, best mates again, and you enjoy playing football.
Yeah. Did your parents, when you were younger, this is going back to when you were in youth or just really, really young playing for your team, did your parents ever do the old score you get £5 or a couple of quid or whatever, a goal?
Yeah.
You must have rinsed them.
I think I was scoring too much, so my dad stopped it.
Yeah,
and
yeah.
He said, and he set a new one. He said, if you score a header, because he knows how bad I am at heading. If you score a header, then I can't remember what he said or how much, but I'll buy some sweets or something like that. Yeah. And I never scored a header until when I was in Holland. That's the only header I've ever scored.
Was that the first goal you scored in Holland? The header?
No, it was in the playoffs. Yeah. I can't remember who was it against. But it was in a playoff game right at the end of the season, and the ball's got crossed in, and I've just glanced it, not knowing where it's going, tried to get my head on it, and it went in the far corner. Yes. I was just like, and I saw him obviously after the game.
Was he there?
How has that just happened? I scored it.
Where's the sweet? Where's the sweet?
Get the sweets out.
Brilliant, mate. That's brilliant. So, mate, I've done a lot of homework on yourself through the youth careers, your loan spells, and I think you even got like a player of the year at Vitesse. I mean, like, it's been incredible, mate. Seriously, like, all the way along, you've succeeded. You've won this, you've won that. You've got player of the year, you scored goals here, goals there, and you've proved yourself. And now you're playing for England, you're captain of Chelsea sometimes, which is incredible to see. Is there, like, what do you look back on all their moments? And is there anything that's, like, really stands out for you as, like, one of them special moments for you? I mean, there's so many of them, it must be hard to choose.
Yeah, it's difficult to choose, and to be fair, I'm not someone that tries to look back too much. I feel like you don't have time to look back. There's another game coming up, or in the summer when the season's finished, you can have a little look back, but then I'm thinking about the next season and what I can do better. It's been a crazy journey so far, and I think having the mentality that I have, I've not made it yet. I'm still not at the point where I want to be. I want to keep getting better. I want to do more. I feel like always having that mentality is the best way to be, and that means you're going to improve and get better and better. And as I said, I'm not where I want to be at the moment. I want to get more. I want to do more and get better. So always have that mentality, and hopefully I can achieve big things.
Brilliant. Well, listen, I'm calling it. We're going to win the World Cup.
Yeah. Right. So that's a big thing I want to achieve.
Help us do it, mate. Here we are. Mate, it's absolute pleasure. Thanks for your time. Thanks, really appreciate it. And we'll see you soon.